हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रभा शर्मा वेलकम यू टू द नेक्स्ट कंटेंट ऑफ द सब डिवीज़न ऑफ जर्नल। टुडे आई विल टेल यू द डिटेल्स रिलेटेड विद द सेल्स बुक, परचेज रिटर्न्स बुक एंड द सेल्स रिटर्न्स बुक्स, द कॉन्सेप्ट एज वेल एज द फॉर्मेट एंड हाउ टू एंटरटेन द दीज बुक्स। फर्स्ट यू मे सी हियर द सेल्स बुक। द सेल्स बुक एंड द परचेज बुक आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड द सिस्टम्स आर द सेम, बट here you have to give the focus only to the all the credit sales made by the business to them. Now it means the sales books records all the credit sales. Like the entry has been passed here, if the goods sold to X, like I am giving the one example here, then the X account debit to sales entry is there. It means the customer account debit to sales entry. Sale body used for the goods only, not for the asset. In the same manner, you have to identify the entries first and then give the focus onto the credit items only. When the entry, if you are going to understand in the journal, and then only that entry will be passed where the entry is customers to sales. Sale word is for goods. So it is called as sale book also. It can be called with the name of sale journal and the sales day book also. But now again I am referring the like the purchase book. I have already told the few conditions. In the same manner, the conditions are to be followed in the sale book. Cash sale of the goods will not be entertained. Credit sale of assets will not be entertained. Cash sale of assets will not be entertained. And any other items related with any credit items which are not related with the goods sold will not be entertained here. Only the goods sold on credit will be entertained here. Now this is the format of the sale book. Again you may see here the one is the date is there, particulars column is the name of customer should be listed here, and the items purchased by him is to be listed here, and the details and the other items like the purchase book you have to make. Like first is I am discussing only the particulars column and the details. Others the columns you have to put the value like the purchase book. The first is like the Verma and Company is the name of the customer. Kolkata is the place you have to write down and give the details of the item which has been sold by the business to the Verma and Company. So here the word is 10 reams white papers at the 200 each has been given the 2000. And the 50 reams at 100, 5000. Then again the makes the total of the both 5000. Then if it is listed with the trade discount, apply the trade discount 10% if it is there, then to be on the 7000. If it is 5%, if it is 10, if it is 20, apply on the total amount of the goods sold. So now here the 6300 after deducting. This is the sale given, sale made to the customers. This is a net price. So after deductions, then it will be considered the value 6300. Now if there is the GST is also needed to be charged, so here the GST will be added. So here the total amount is in the same manner, the total will be done. And now the cost column input in the same like purchase book you have to make and elaborate this details column into the different columns of the sale book. 6300 should be put in front of the cost parallel, and then that GST in the column of GST, and then the total will be charged. In the same manners you have to pass the others. This is for the 1st February I have listed here. If the others items are given to you, you may also entertain here one by one given the dates, and at the end of the question you have to make the total of the all the analytical columns, all the others columns. And now if the total is to be shown, the how much value of the cost has been sold, then input or the CGST, SGST or the IGST charged, and the freight paid, and the total will be made. So this is given you the total columns details. Through the detail column it will be elaborated into the different books. So I think this is the format is just like the sale book. But here only the change is related with only one. The name of customer will take the place in place of suppliers. So I think this is clear to you now. And now I am moving to the next content, purchase returns book. When the purchase book is there, if the goods on credit purchase and returns, then this book will be placed. If the goods purchased on cash and then returns, it will go to the cash book. So the purchase returns book is also related with the goods purchased on credit and now returned. So this book is used to record the all the returns of the goods by the business to the supplier. When I am talking all means only the credit purchase book is there, then only to returns to suppliers. This entry is for the purchase return books are usually made to the basis of debit note. Debit note means now the name of the supplier is to be debited. That's why the debit note as a source document, you know what is the meaning of the debit note. That means the debit note is maintained for the, this is a one part of your document, source document. It is to be maintained for the returning the goods. And this can be called, we call the debit note because the supplier account is debited here with the amount written in the note also. Now you may see here the same format of the purchase returns like the you have already purchased from the purchase book from the Brown and Company Kolkata. Now out of the few items you are returning. So one ream is returning, two ream is returning of the 600 and 500. Calculate the figures now here, and then trade discount is also deducted with the same value the goods purchased. If it is purchased already from the purchase book, it is, if it is related with the 10%, again you have to at the time of returning the 10% will be applied. This is the format of purchase return book. By mistake has been written by purchase book, but this is the format of your purchase returns books. So after deducting the 5%, that is related with the 5% on 1980, that means 1980, you have to apply the rate. This also the same already applied on the purchase book. So calculate the figure. And then again and again, after the first Feb, 2 Feb, 3rd Feb, then if the name of the persons are different, name of suppliers may be different, and give the details in the same manner, the purchase book will be maintained. And now I am moving to the sale returns book. The sale book, returns book is the book is to be used to record all the returns of the goods to the business by the customer. It means the customer is returning the goods to business. Then the credit note will be made. This is also the one source document, and in the source document given the full details related with the credit note. But the credit note here the meaning is only when the goods returned by the customer, then the credit note will be made, the name of customer will be credited. So now we call a credit note customer is credited. And the same manners you may see here the work related with the one diagram is also given. It means this is also the disclosure of your debit and credit notes. Now I am moving to the next one is related with the same as I have discussed about the format of the purchase returns books. You have to make for the sale returns book, but the name of customer will be changed only. In the purchase returns books, we are entering supplier's name, or in the sale returns books, we are entering customer's name and the place. Thank you.